Hello everybody and welcome back to yet another tutorial. My name is Nawri Radwan and you are tuned to photomanipulation.com. In this video, I will show you how to add or grow IV trees on your subjects in Photoshop. If you are an artist that likes to work on post-apocalypse scenes like The Last of Us, you will love this tutorial. But before I do that, I have an announcement to make. I have been planning to do the full-length artwork tutorials live on our PM Photo Manipulation Discord server. So if you haven't joined yet, I will be leaving the link in the description down below. And without any further ado, let's start with this tutorial. So this is before and this is after. I will show you first how to add these branches right here, and then I will show you how to add these leaves right here and how to merge the color and the lighting. Let's start first by adding the IV texture. Just look for an IV texture that looks like that, that's only showing the IV leaves. What I will do before I turn that to a texture or a pattern, go to image size, and make sure to decrease the size of that image from whatever it is to 312. And make sure it's 312 on both width and height. So make sure it's a square. Then click OK. The reason why I decreased the size of the image because I want the IV trees or the IV leaves to look as small as it can be. After you decrease the size of that image, click on Edit, then click on Define Pattern. Name it IV Texture. Let's go back to the document and let's zoom on the areas that we want to add the IV to. Let's add a new empty layer. Then let's click on the Freeform Pen tool. Now, I want you to start drawing random lines like that. And while drawing that lines, I want you to think of it as the IV tree branches. As if it's growing like that, then start to spread on different directions. If you don't know how the IV tree grows, you can see a reference image from Google. For me, because it's a tutorial, I'm going to start painting randomly. Also, if you don't want lines to collapse, just click and hold Shift while you are painting those lines or drawing these lines. After drawing those lines, click the brush tool. Make sure the hardness is on 100%. Make sure the size is too small to imitate the size of the branch. While clicking on the new layer, click on B, which is the brush, then click on Enter. It gave me a black stroke. I will change that color to a color that looks like a branch color. Click on B, then Enter. This is going to be our branch stroke. Let's add a new empty layer, another one. Then let's select the pattern stamp tool. On that preview right here, we will select the pattern that we just created of the IV leaves. Next, click on the brush preview right here and select a brush that looks like a leaf. Now click on F5. That will bring the brush settings. What we care for here is the shape dynamics and the scattering. For the shape dynamics, make sure the size jitter is all the way up to 100%. For the angle jitter, make sure it's all the way up to the 100%. These other options doesn't matter, just make sure to click on the flip on the X and Y jitter. On the scattering, we will change between the scatter and the count. Make sure the both axes is checked. And now we will start experimenting. To see how the IV tree will look, just click on S, E, and then click on Enter. So this is how it looks now. I don't want it to look like that because the shape of our brush is too big for the IV tree. To fix that, I will decrease the size of the brush. I will make it 30. And then let's click on S again and then Enter. Yeah, this looks like a better result. Now, let's add a new empty layer, another one. and let's change the count and let's increase the scatter. And then let's click on enter again. Let's do the same step again and change the count and increase the scatter. And then let's click on S and enter. Now we got this result right here. Let's hide the brush settings by clicking on F5. I will click on the bend tool, then click delete. That will delete the lines that we painted or the strokes. For now, I'm going to hide these IV layers to only show the branch layer. Now it looks like it's just a stroke. Let's give it more depth. And that's by clicking 2 times on that layer of the stroke. Let's name it stroke. And let's click 2 times. That will bring the layer style menu. Let's add bevel and emboss. Reset to default. Let's uncheck the use global light. Let's give it, let's decrease the screen light highlights mode. Let's decrease the highlights and increase the shadow. Let's give it more depth. Decrease the size. Maybe less shadows. Now, let's give it a texture. Click on texture and from the pattern preview right here, we will select the tree menu and then we will click on the tree trunk. If you don't have those, just click on that icon right here and then click on append default patterns. Then click OK and it will give you this tree and grass and water. Again, click on the tree, then select the tree trunk. Decrease the depth just a bit and decrease the scale. For now, this is going to be our IV branch. Let's go back to the IV tree. We will merge all of the 3 layers together. Let's make a copy of that layer by clicking on Ctrl J. Let's add a black background beneath it and merge them together. Click Ctrl A to select the whole canvas. Then click Ctrl C to copy. Now, let's hide this layer right here. And then let's click on Q to enter the quick mask mode. Then click Ctrl V to paste. As you can see, now we pasted it on the quick mask mode. To exit the quick mask mode, click on Q again, and now we have the selection. Click on the layer of the IV tree and add that as a mask. As you can see, we have that now as a mask. Now let's delete that layer that we made, and let's make another copy of that layer of the IV tree. Let's hide it for now. Click on the mask of the first IV layer, then click on Ctrl L. That will bring the levels menu. And now we will start to add contrast. Bring back some of the leaves. Click on the layer of the second IV tree. Let's delete the mask from it. Click 2 times. That will bring the layer style menu. On the blend if option, select the green channel. Take that slide on the current layer to the left side, or to the right side, sorry. Make sure not to go too far, just enough distance to get out of that dark area. Then click on OK. Convert that to a smart object, and then rasterize it. Now let's merge both layers together. I want to hide this bottom area of the IV tree. To do that, make another copy. We will use that as a mask by going to layer, layer mask from transparency. That will give us the mask. Click and hold Alt and drag it to the second layer and let's delete that one. Click on the blur tool. Make sure the strength is on 10% and let's blur some areas at the bottom. Then let's use the gradient tool. Then let's click on the gradient tool. Make sure we select the transparent one on the basics preset. Make sure it's on the linear gradient shape. On the mode, select Vivid Light. Make sure the color is black and drag from the bottom to the top. Just like that. Now apply the mask. Click two times on that layer. And then add a drop shadow. For the color, select a dark area from the wall. Make sure it's a soft light. You can increase it or decrease it later. Play with the size and the distance until you get something that looks realistic. For me, this one looks great, so I will click on OK. I will decrease the size of the IV just a bit. Now what is left to do is just blend the colors and fix the lighting. So this is how I add the IV tree. This is it for today's tutorial. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. I hope you learned something new. If you did, show me that by clicking on the like button. Also follow us on our social media and don't forget to grab my Digital Landscape Reloaded course if you want to see more advanced tips and tricks. Also join our Discord server. I will leave all of the links in the description down below. I'll see you in the next tutorials. Peace.